Hey guys, it's Convolva here, and today we're going to see how we can tripletize anything inside FL Studio. Alright, so before we begin, I'm going to show you a little preview of what this sounds like, and then we're going to actually create it. So here I've got the original WAV file, and after processing, it becomes this one. So let's hear it. And now the tripletized version. All right. So as you can see, we went from a 1/4th beat time signature to a 1/3 time signature. But before we go further into it, I would like to say full disclosure, this is more of a inspirational technique rather than a sound design technique, because it introduces some kind of artifacts, you know, in the high end, which sounds a little robotic sometimes. See where you can actually use this. I tend to use it mostly to get inspiration for remixes and stuff like that. But yeah, let's see how to go about it. So to get to this sound, what I'm going to do is pass this sound through the mixer by clicking here on the track. And currently it's going into the 10th mixer slot. And here I'm going to add gross beat. So in gross beat, you are given this interface where you have all these pre-built time-based effects, which you can choose, and that changes how the audio sounds when it goes through gross beat. For example, we have this complex 6, it sounds like this. And this is probably something which most of you guys might be familiar with, but gross beat does come with more presets. If you right click here in the preset, you get all these options. And what we are going to use for this tutorial is the third one, which is called momentary. And inside momentary, we have all these different kinds of preset, which are not there in the default one, which comes when you open gross beat. So for this one, we are going to go with the slow triplet preset, and it sounds something like this. Oh, I like that, man. The first time I noticed this, I was really surprised that you could do this with gross beat, as I always used to think it's more for, you know, just scratching effects or time-based volume automation, stuff like that. But this preset was quite interesting to look at. So you might have noticed that it sounds as if the track has become triplets, but the pitch has come down. And that is true because it's a time-based effect, so the way it's achieving that triplet is by slowing down the track per beat, and then it's like repeating the process. So to actually get it back to pitch, what you need to do is record this audio that is being processed by gross beat and then pitch it up. So for now, I'm going to add an Edison right after gross beat to record it. So I'm going to right click, double click on Edison, and I'm going to change this to on play so that it records when I play it. And then I'm going to hit record to arm the Edison and then hit play here. Alright, I'm going to hit stop now. So let's bring this into the timeline by clicking on this and dragging it into the timeline, making sure not to drop it on, no, don't do that. Just drop it on the timeline in an empty space where you don't have any samples, because you don't want to replace any sample. And as you know, FL does not have a undo button for that. So it's weird, guys, do something about it. Like, seriously. But yeah, anyway, just drop it somewhere here and let's remove this for now, because this is the new sample. Yeah. So now we're going to double click on this and bring up the audio clip settings and change the mode to stretch. So I've noticed that it brings down the pitch by 5 semitones. So let's increase the range to 5 semitones here and then pitch it up. Let's hear it now. And there you go. You got a tripletized version of your original audio file which you had. Now, it doesn't have to be just audio files. You can actually do this with patterns and stuff like that inside your playlist. So here, I've got this hammer pluck sound. Alright, before we go into that, I need to mention something. And that is to make sure that the audio that you're working with is in the same BPM as the project's BPM. If you have some different BPM like this, this effect might not work for you. So let's see that by changing it to 159. You see how it goes all out of time and everything. So that's not what we want. Make sure it is in the same BPM. Now in this case, I know that the BPM of this audio is 150, so I chose the project's BPM as 150. So that's something to keep in mind. And the next thing to keep in mind is to use the snapping in bar or beat. This is because if you start somewhere in between, like if I have a 1/2 snapping and I'm playing from somewhere in between, it will still make the mistake of, you know, not tripletizing exactly like the way you want it. So let's see how this one sounds. Which might be cool in some cases, but you know, most often than not, this is not really what people are looking for when they say, you know, they want to tripletize something. So a good way to go about it is to select the bar setting here in the snapping and then just play it from the beginning of any bar. Much better. Now, you don't have to work with audio for this. This also works with patterns because it's an effect in the mixer slot. So you can actually pass any synth or something which you wrote MIDI for in 1/4 timing. And you don't want to go through the manual work of actually going into 1/3 and making sure everything is snapping to 1/3 time signature. So in that case, that could work really well. All you have to do is just pass this through the mixer slot, open gross beat, go into momentary and select that preset and you would get triplet. Which I think works really well for this. And all you need to do is just open up Edison and arm it to play and record again. Stop the recording, remove the excess, bring it to the timeline and repitch it with the stretch mode by 5 semitones and you get the triplet version. This is nice to get a feel of what it would sound if you were to write it in triplet before actually going inside the plugin and manually changing everything to triplet. Now, I usually use this for remixing a track or if I've written the drop one of a track and I want to make a triplet drop for the second drop or something like that. And I want to quickly see how it would sound. So for example, I would have a track like this where I would light the first drop and let's remove it for now. It would sound something like this. And I would want to see how it would sound in triplets. So I would just put gross beat and listen to it. I think works really well for this case. Also, it doesn't have to be just drops or melodies like this. You can use it for literally anything. So in this track, I used it for the intro as well, and it sounded really cool. which I find really cool. So yeah, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and if you found this helpful, then consider hitting the like and subscribe button.